So guys, in this video we are going to perform this LLMNR poisoning and getting the hash of the user. So go to the Chrome and type the responder python. You will get this spiderlabs responder GitHub repository and click on this, click on that. So guys, this is the repository and you can see the usage here and also the features. So let's go ahead and clone this. I have already cloned this, just copy this and do the git clone. So I have cloned this into this desktop directory. You can see here, let's go into this responder directory and quickly say ls. So there is a python file. So we need to run this python file directory using python. So first let's see whether it's python 2 or python 3. So we can cat responder.py and we will grep for python print statement. So we can see easily we can specify the either this is python 2 or 3 using this print statement. So it's I think it's python 3. Think it's python 2. So let's try both, not a problem. So let's run python responder dot py. So let's say minus h for help option. So you can see bunch of options here and version help analyze. So this will analyze the client version, that means the OS version and etc. And you need to specify this interface and this R for NetBIOS ready suffix queries, and sometimes it will break the system, and D for NBTNS domain. So if the computer is asking for NBTNS, then you should answer this one. And you can type this, you can use this minus F switch for the fingerprinting the OS version also. And you can also start the WPAD rogue proxy server. So this WPAD vulnerability is from the internet options. So if you put the automatically locate the proxy, then we will impersonate as the main proxy. So let's go ahead and run the python responder. First we need to run this python responder, and then what we are going to do is we are going to this Windows 7 computer and we need to search for some file that is not exist in any network share. So let's go ahead and run this python responder.py, and we need to specify this interface name, right? So let's say ifconfig. So this WLP3S0 is the interface name, and specify this here. And then what you want to do is we want to specify some options, D if it uses NBTNS, and R and W for DPAD, and we can also press give the F option for fingerprinting the OS version. So I think these are enough. So responder must be run as root. So let's go ahead and run as root. Alright, now we have got two errors, 443.80. So there are some Apache server running on. So let's kill this Apache. So now let's run this script again. 443. I think that's not a problem. So all right, so we are reasoning for events. You can see bunch of options here, and we have a bunch of poisoners. LLMNR is automatically set to on, and NBTNS set to on, DNS is automatically set to on, and servers, so these are set to on by default, and WPAD proxy we have specified this W option, and HTTPS option. You can also set up the local listener and send the reversal to that computer and get the reversal. So you can also set the analyze mode to get basic information. So let's go ahead and type the some non-existent file, that is nickel. Now after pressing enter, you get this, click on cancel. So poison answer sent to this IP for name nickel, skipping previously captured hash. So let's say another one. I think just before recording this video, I have tried this nickel. Let's say nickel 2. So let's close this and run again. Now let's say Windows 11. So it has already previously captured the hash. So let's say ls and let's go to logs. Type ls and you can see this smb ntrm hash. So this is the hash I have already previously captured this before recording of this video. So let's delete this hash. So let's save y. So now let's go ahead and run our responder. All right, now let's go ahead and say Windows 11. So all right guys, it's already captured the hash in the previous just before recording of this video. I just tried this tool and it has worked. So you get this hash here when you are performing for the first time. So all you have to do is you need to go to logs. So in the logs you will get the hash. Think it's alright, just for demonstration of this video, let's create a new user. I think there is another user name of text. So let's see. So let's say test. This is the standard account, create account. So let's go ahead and log off and log in that as of that user test. So let's click on this test. I did not put the password. So let's create the password for Shri. test. So now let's go ahead and run this responder. So now let me say Windows 11. As you can see, as you guys can see, now it has poisoned for the name Windows 11 and we have got this test. So now we can copy this hash into a text file and you can use this John the Ripper to crack this. So in our case, the password is very weak and John the Ripper will crack in a seconds. So it is just a test. So in case the administrator put the strong password, then it will be very tough. So click on cancel. So what happened here is there will be a challenge request for this user, for this responder, and so let me show you this in the Wireshark so that you can get much more clarity. So now let's choose this Ethernet interface. Let's say ip.dst destination is equals to my IP address. Now let's go ahead and press enter. So there will be so many packets. Let's stop here for now. You can see first the protocol is TCP. It's using this TCP handshake, three-way handshake, and then the SMB negotiation protocol response. You can see here NetBIOS and SMB message here, and if you know, you can scroll down. I think you can follow this stream. So we have got some information about this Windows 7. You can see Windows 7 Ultimate 7601 service pack. So if you can gather all the information, it will be like that. So basically the Windows 7 machine has been sending the request to us. It's like NTLM challenge message. You can see here. Basically, we got only this message, right? Windows 7 Ultimate 7601 service pack. But if you create new user and if you do the same, and we'll get the hash also. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope you have understood this responder to gather the hash of the user.